Interested in the curious creature mounts? Well, you've come to the right place, because here you will find all the mounts with some cheeky recolors too. There are timestamps below, as well as links to the Guild Wars 2 wiki for all curious creature mounts. So let's tie knot and dive into some yummy mount candy goodness, along with my own personal headcanon for the origins of these beautiful beasts. The Archaius Sprinter are a migratory species of raptor who have their breeding grounds in Sparkfly Fen. Kettles of Archaius can be seen making their way through Mount Maelstrom and skirting the coast of Thunderhead Peak as they take their young to the lush feeding grounds of the Alonan Riverlands. On the night of Aurene's ascension, at a Melandru's requiem in Siren's Landing, a miraculous event occurred. Eyewitnesses report a brilliant light radiating from the fallen idol of the goddess, a light which enveloped all in its presence. Creatures touched by the goddess's light gained bioluminescence, whilst affected sapient races spoke of visions of a new world beyond the mists. All Geode mounts are created by the Brotherhood of the Dragon in Thunderhead Peaks. Over the centuries, the dwarves gain a greater understanding of the ritual which transformed their race from flesh and blood to stone. After the creation of the dragon blood weapons, and with the help of the Zephyrite Choir, they created the Geode creatures for both utility and eternal companionship. The Ring of Fire is an island chain south of the Tarnished Coast and is the birthplace of all volcanic mounts. The region was infested with ancient magic when the Elder Dragon Primordus awoke. Driven to the brink of sanity by his corruption, it was the druid spirits who freed these extraordinary creatures from the dragon's yoke. They have proven themselves indispensable allies in the Dragon Wars. Darkmist mounts all hail from the domain of the Lost Spirit Realm, where creatures cruelly killed by Balthasar's forged armies linger. As Krokodoric devoured the mists, many Darkmists were able to escape that realm and return to the mortal plane. Darkmist Moorhounds have been seen at dusk in the deep desert. Travelers are advised to keep their distance. Sleek Dunerunners are the messengers of the Djinn High Council, loyal and exceptionally fleet. These creatures are often seen in the service of heads of state, diplomats, and robber barons alike. The Order of Whispers too utilizes these beings, and it is believed that they were the first to barter the High Council for the service of the Dunerunners. Luminous mounts were created by the minions of the Mad King Thorn. Fond of trickery, one fateful Halloween in 1331, King Thorn's servants rounded up all the creatures of Lion's Arch and, quote, dressed them for the occasion, throwing them into a cauldron. Thorn was so enamored with the results of this horrific crime, he dubbed them luminous members of his court, kidnapping many of these changed creatures and taking them to the Mad Realm. Many were rescued, and now they are sought after for their unusual history and appearance. What do we call awakened mounts are actually risen primeval war mounts, their regala marking them as the mounts of the palace guard. It was Palawa Joko who resurrected these creatures to service his generals. With the defeat of his forces and his reported demise, many of these creatures have been taken by allied forces as the spoils of war. H. hailing from the far Shiver Peak Mountains, the Vigilant Saberclaw is the master of the battlefield. Fearless and inexhaustible, they are favored by mist warriors and bandits alike. In the wild, they are, like most mountain big cats, solitary hunters. Sadly, the rise of Jormag has pushed many large predators to the brink of extinction, and the Saberclaw is no exception. And the legacy of the Brotherhood of the Dragon is long, and the Forgotten forged many allies in secret and recruited not only sapient races, but all who could offer service to the cause. Exalted Mist Champions stalk the lush forests at the heart of the Maguma jungle, bringing a swift death to the minions of Mordremoth. Hailing from Krytan, the Gendarran Hawkeye is one of the first tamed and trained griffon species of the region. Expert griffon masters from the Order of the Sunspear have, for the first time, opened their doors to non-affiliated trainees. There is, of course, a rigorous vetting process for would-be griffon trainers, but with thousands of applications and hundreds already in training, the skies of Krytan could soon be filled with these magnificent creatures. The Lithosol were first sighted on Draconis Mons, and it is widely believed that they were created by the Druids, although Asura explorers have claimed that it was the legendary Sensational Zin who made the Lithosoids whilst attempting to terraform Draconis Mons. Zin founded Ratanovis and Arcanum and was instrumental in the defeat of the White Mantle and Massad, as well as having a personal beef with Polarajoko, so it is entirely possible he had his tiny malevolent hands in the creation of these entities. Further investigation is required. The trend in painted mounts continues with the Moth-Marked Skyscale, and if you're looking for this particular art style, head to Dr. Blint's encampment in Metrica Province. The good doctor uses ooze pigment to create long-lasting, non-toxic pigments, which he claims enhances mount speed too, although those claims have yet to be verified, and he is under investigation by the Arcane Council for false advertising. After the defeat of the old god Doom, eyewitnesses have spoke of miracles being performed at the Reaper's Gate in Lochnar's Pass. Pilgrims to the Shrine of Grenth reported the transformation of their mounts. The Frostsoul Skyscale is one such example. The High Priestess of Grenth, Rhea, is investigating the claims at the shrine and was quick to remind followers that one of the god's lesser-known titles is the Prince of Winter. The Venomous Greathorn was first sighted in the Gnarled Grove on the Dragonfall Isles. As its name suggests, this subspecies of Skyscale has a venomous bite, making its taming and training exceedingly challenging. Hunters Keem and his companion Bard Bohai have had some success in this endeavour thanks to their extensive knowledge of and resilience to biotoxins. Prospective owners must complete a 6-week care and safety training programme to foster this most unusual Skyscale. So, we come to the end. That's my curious mount showcase and personal headcanon origins of these species. If you would like to see these wonderful creatures get some in-game lore and love, please do let the devs know and let me know what your favourite curious creature is in the comments below. And whilst you're down there, please do like this video if indeed you did like it, share it with someone you think might enjoy it, subscribe to my channel for more Guild Wars 2 goodness in the future, and please do show some love to Arthur, Why You Need My Name, Cody, Kildare, Cub, Molini, Jolly Joestar, Dark Griever, and all of my wondrous, fantabulous Patreons at whom I would be unable to dedicate the time and resources I do to my content creation. I can never thank you all enough. If you'd like to join my band of nerdy awesome, links to my Patreon page below. And if you feel inspired to jump into Guild Wars 2, there are referral links down there as well for both the free-to-play game and the Path of Fire expansion, which now includes all the content from the Heart of Thorns expansion. 2, thanks to the generosity of ArenaNet and their partner program, of whom I am a proud affiliate, using any other referral links directly supports my channel, but costs you, my dear friend, not a penny more. But sadly, we have come to the very end. So, until we meet again, please stay safe, stay awesome, and thank you so much for watching.